stupid thing. Anyway, if there's a Muslim want to call me and they want to show us what if the Quran have a miracle or Muhammad he says something amazing, we would like to hear, no problem.
Okay, yeah, of course. You know, yeah, when I get some ideas, I just tell you, because I'm not a Muslim anymore.
I'm happy for you, my friend. Yeah.
Since a week, I only watching your videos the whole day and laughing my soul out of me. Since a week, I just watching your videos and don't stop to laugh. Two topics, okay. If you want to talk a little bit about it. First topic is most Muslims today claim that the Bible and the Torah is false by the time. Is there a proof of their claim in the Quran, or is it just excuse so that they can call that their religion make further more sense? You know what I mean?
Actually, this is absolutely against the Quran teaching, and the Quran confirm what is with possessed in the hand of the Christians and the Jews. So here you will see, as an example, in chapter chapter 2, verse number 89,
yes,
chapter 2, 91, chapter 2, 101, chapter 2, verse number 213. Look how many chapter, all right? Actually, no, delete 213. Three chapters in front of us, at least here.
Yes, yes.
It says here, and this is the Muslim translation. Read it carefully. What it says? This is chapter 2, verse number 89. Do you see what it says?
It's in Arabic.
No, in English. I'm showing you in English.
Yeah, I have to wait a little bit. So it comes. Okay, okay, okay. And when there comes to them a, and then I can read anymore, book from Allah confirming what is with them, although from of all they had prayed for victory against those.
That's it. Confirming what is with them. How you can confirm what is with them, and then you say to us, our book is corrupt.
Yeah.
If Allah, Allah confirm what is with us and it is wrong, it means Allah is a false too.
Yeah, I understand. No. So it after the Muslims can see the Bible and that are many contradictions to their religion, then they told the claim. You know what I mean?
My friend, at the end of the day, when a Muslim he accused the Bible to be corrupt, he's talking about the Bible of Allah.
Yeah.
So what is my problem? I love, you know, if a Muslim he want to say to me from now until 10,000 years from now that the Bible of Allah is corrupt, I love. I said, okay. So what's my problem? Go ask your God why his book is corrupt, because this is the Bible of Allah. We don't believe in Allah. He sent the Bible. You believe in Allah sent the Bible. Okay, ask your God, Allah, how stupid he is to the point he sent books he cannot protect.
Yeah, of course.
So what's my problem?
But the thing is, they not even have a point where then can where they can make this claim. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but they cannot. And, you know, most of the Muslims are copy-paste. But as long as the Muslims agree that the one who sent the Torah and the one who sent the gospel is Allah, so shouldn't they ask Allah, why Allah, you sent the book, but you don't want it to protect the book? They say to us, Allah will protect only the Quran. But this is mean that Allah, he's elective in his words. That's mean he favors some words over some other words. So this is not my fault. This is his fault. The book belongs to the author, not to the reader. You know, if somebody sent me a book, and then this book I found it's corrupt. Now, is it my fault as a reader, or it's a fault as an author? He did not protect his book, especially if he is divine God. He's not just a man. You see, for me, I have books. If somebody tried to play with my books, I can sue him, take him to court. Right?
Yeah.
So I can still protect my books. This is God who can destroy anyone who want to do something.
Yeah.
So why he sent a book and the Muslims saying to us that his book is corrupted? That's additional proof that Allah is weak God and he is fake God.
Yes.
You know? And this additional proof that he cannot be the one who sent the gospel. You know?
Yes.
In different verse in the Quran, it says that nobody can exchange the word of Allah. So how nobody can exchange the word of Allah? And then we find that's, you know, the Muslims themselves, they say it is, you know, the word of Allah is changed. The Quran mentioned in one place that the Jews use the word tahrif, but it doesn't say they are changing the book or what they are saying. The story behind that they change the location of the verses from its places. They displace this place. And if you go into the interpretation, you will see it says they change the interpretation of it, not corrupting the book. You know.
Okay.
So here, this is the only verse speaking about. And of the Jews, there are those who displace words from their right place. But if you go and see the story, you will see that Muhammad. The Jews, they asked him to be a judge about a woman who committed adultery, and a Jew, he put his hand over the line in the book to hide the word that says stone them, you know. And this is what this is about. He just put his hand there. It's not even changed in the creation, you know. It's just he put his hand to hide the sentence.
And this is what the interpretation
says, you know. So it doesn't say anywhere that really they changed the book. And even if so, here we go. We have this will be contradiction in the Quran, because the Quran says in many places that Allah confirmed what is between their hands,
and contradiction to the
and not to forget that Muhammad himself, he took an oath
on the
Torah. Okay, so how it's corrupt, and then you take an oath in the Torah, you know, that means you are corrupt too.
Make no sense. You know? Okay, Another question. Why, it's a question what I didn't understand as a Muslim until now, why they claim that Jesus wasn't crucified?